watching Didi Croy with my favorite groomer on YouTube.
This is Edward. We are mobile grooming today, and we are going to do a little more than half off of his body. And it's been a while since he's gotten grooming, she said, but I mean, he's not mad or anything. So I've got my 10 blade. I'm starting with my 10. We're going to do everything that we need to...
He's really watching David over here.
So I'm going to do my 10 blade, and I'm going to do face sanitary. Everywhere I'm going to use my 10. And I think I'm already planned on doing a 4-guard, but I'm going to try a 2-guard first. I haven't brushed him. His hair doesn't seem matted or anything, so I'm going to just get right to it so we can move quickly. Okay, right here I'm going to grab his jawbone and come in here. He's moving a lot looking around at the camera and stuff, so pick your choice of grunts or whatever you're going to use to get attention. You can go can do that, or hold the jawbone and the head bone. You need control of the eyes here. You don't want to nick them in any way. It's pretty cold here in Texas today. It's going to be warmer than it was yesterday, but it's like 30 something degrees right now. So David got the trailer all ready for me. Got everything set up. So I just swiped out using the corners of my 10. Swiped out. Since it's cold, everything's cold. The wire's cold on my clippers. So I'm gonna use the 10, right? Get my 10 blade. For time efficiency, this is the best way to do it. If you got your 10 blade on there, do everything you need to do with the 10 blade as best you can. So there's not like a bunch of going back and forth. We're just using the 10 everywhere. I'm gonna get my 2-guard, which it says, it doesn't say on here.
It says on there though.
Okay. I'm gonna come check my, I'm gonna use this, since I'm not sure if this is what I wanna use, I'm gonna try it on the back first, right here on the haunch, the hip. And I think I'm gonna stay right here, so I'm gonna do, I'm not taking my time, I'm moving. I'm not rushing, but I'm not wasting a minute, you know what I'm saying? So, you guys out there that are like, you're grooming too fast, well, hey, you're grooming too slow. You shouldn't have a dog for 2-3 hours, 4-hour grooming. I don't think so. So, move, keep moving. Because if you've ever worked at PetSmart, you know you're doing 20, 30 dogs in that day by yourself. So, this is where you learn to groom fast. You want to knock out all the dogs you can knock out by yourself. Some of you get it, some of you don't. Okay. I'm gonna do a little bit of something here for this Navy personnel who's starting his grooming career out in California. I'm going to show him what to do here because he doesn't have a guard. He's grooming a dog this weekend. A Yorkie. He's grooming a Yorkie on Saturday. So I'm going to show him, if you just had a 10 blade, what you could do with this area. Save that for Andrew. And if I'm going to hand scissor the legs, I might as well just come back with my 4-guard. 4-guard is going to be shorter than the 2-guard. So here's my 2. I'm going to actually go 2 down on the head. And there's a lot of pulling here. This dog's kind of backing up, pulling and stuff. A lot of moving around, moving the head. So maneuver what you need here. Get a good tight hold on the chin. I've still got my 2. I'm going to go down, but I'm not trying to take off a lot of length. I'm not pushing too hard. I'm just going to shape this all out. Again, I didn't brush this. You can brush it out before you keep going. I am not loving that, but I'm gonna, once we clean it up more, grab the chin here. We did the 2 on the body, so that's all we're doing right here is extending the around the neck, 2 down. For me, I don't use any when I'm using the guards. I only use a 10. There's some people that use a 30. So you used to be able to use like a 40. This is still my two guard. I'm kind of just doing a little bit of reverse, a little bit of down. Just trying to get some of this out. We'll finalize it up nicely after the groove. Because it's messy right now. Okay, let me get... Okay, Andrew just has, right now he just has this, some kind of scissor that looks like this, okay? I told him not to use it on the face. I prefer not to use something so pointy on the face. So he does, he's able to probably use it here. Because he doesn't have a guard, so he just has a 10. Use your hand here. You can kind of create the bottom and come down and cut your, using the 10 blade only, like, cause that's okay. He has some kind of clippers. That's basically all he has. So I'm creating right here. I'm just cutting all that out, like just with the back of my hand, right? You can do that everywhere here. If I go straight to the body, I'm going to take a 10 to the body. We don't want to do that. Then the other way he can do it is he can brush this all out like this. Make sure you understand where it's at, and he's going to come down this way. If I didn't use a 10 at all, he can still do the same thing. Just he's gonna come straight down this way and straight across, creating a line there. Watch this skin flap here. Just create like a go like that. Just kind of create a little dip in there. Know where your skin flap is before you're doing that, or put your finger here. Kind of understand where you're cutting. But you can go straight down this way and then cut this way. If he's gonna do all the legs, he can do the legs like this. But I mean, this is a full haircut. I told him just wait till he gets these other scissors so he can work on working with the face and everything. But the other scissors he'll be able to use everywhere. So Andrew, I sent you these type of scissors. They are ones that I actually use. They need sharpening. I sent him some dull scissors so he can learn. Know where your pad's at. I already know where it's at, but if you don't know where your pad's at before you start trimming anything. You can keep it here if you want. Watch your scissors here. Don't let someone kick them off. Bring all that up so you can see it. Move the hair and so forth. I'm doing a four guard down the leg, so I'm just showing you. Just come around and create your roundness here. After you've brushed the hair, you'll have a better look, though. I'm doing a four guard, doesn't matter. Andrew, you got a two guard and a four guard in your package. So you can see the difference. The two guard here, now I'm gonna take the, it basically is like scissoring. So I'm gonna take the four guard down the legs. Doing the guard is gonna save me time anyway. It's gonna save me time on scissoring. So I can go faster with the guard than I can scissoring, right? Because you don't wanna cut the dogs, you can't like scissor all this fast. There's some matting right there. I'm going to come back with my 10. So straight down on the legs here. Straight down. If you can't get it because it's dirty, then go sideways. Come down this way. Once we wash the hair, we're going to see it just a little less choppy. Lightly, because I'm doing a 2. I'm already here with the 4, so I can see where I've missed the tail a little bit. Just kind of lightly with the 4 because I'm here. Go up. Just 40 here, ready? So I can do the pads and then we're gonna go to the back. The 40 is like a surgical blade. It's gonna take off a lot of hair. If you dig too hard in the pads, you will break up skin, so don't dig too hard. If they're matted, you honestly can't help it. If you got pads that are matted and you're digging and you get blood, you can't help that. The mats need to come out, so don't leave the mats behind. But this guy's not having that issue. Pull the leg back like as if he was gonna jump onto the bed or something. Be careful not to pull the leg back and out. Watch the knee there. I'm actually looking at everything I'm doing while I'm doing it right now. I'm looking at the nails, like I'm analyzing all kinds of stuff. I'm watching his head, his body movement, his panting. I'm seeing how much nails I'm gonna take off, and it looks like I can see the vein on most of them, so there's not gonna be very much to take off. Upside down, it's just wasted. It's like slowing me down. They're all upside down. So clean your blades and turn them back. Like the next day before you groom, turn them back up upright. Before we go to the bath, I'm gonna go ahead and do the ears. I just thought like maybe if he doesn't like the blow dry, then his ears will be done already. This is just a 10. If you don't know about grooming, don't do the ears. Just skip the ears. If you don't know yet, just skip the ears. Because you can easily slice the ear here. Skip the ears until you get some training. So, point tip, I'm holding my leather. That's the meat of the ear. And creating just this area where you can see it, and we'll trim it up in a minute. Moving around quite a bit, moving his face around, so be careful. Hold the leather right there in your finger so you can see where to stop and go, where to cut, where not to cut, where there's skin, where there's not skin. If you can't feel the leather, don't be cutting over there. Feel where it ends on my thumb, so I know where I'm going to be able to cut. So I'm using my sharp scissors, remember? These are not my favorite thing. I'm just showing you, if you have something like this, is what you could be doing. It'll work. It's not what I prefer, but you can make it happen. But it can also do a lot of damage if you have a dog moving around too much. So that's why you're going to come over and use your rounded tip. Hold the jawbone here so you got control. David's doing over here today. Shh. I don't like to grab the whiskers, but sometimes there's like tons. So just do what you can. Watch the tongue. The dog keeps moving his head, fighting it a little bit. Stop. Stop. Pick your words that you want to use. I'm keeping his mouth shut here. I'm going to move all this hair that he's sucking on, which causes rotten teeth and true plaque buildup. Move it out of his mouth. Keeps licking it back in there, right? You can smell his breath. It's really nasty. But he's an older pet. This is my thinning shears or blending shears. Hey, what are you doing, man? Look how rotten his teeth are, you guys. See that? It's abscessed all the way to the top of the gum there. This is what I'm smelling. Look at this. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. Poor baby. Something's in there. I'm going to pull it out. Like food or something, or hair. Look at this. Look at this. Oh my goodness. Look at this. I'm so sorry. Get out of the light. This is all painful. Don't think it's not, just because they're not saying something. But I really want to help them if I can here. Checking the looseness. That. Making sure there's nothing else I can pull out for him. Yeah, definitely needs one more dental. Okay. We're going to go to the bath and we'll come back. Thanks for watching. Make sure if you need any of the stuff I'm using, please order with us. That's how you're getting this free training and education. And just support us by ordering any products that you need. Scissors, blades, clippers. Go to our website down below. We appreciate your business and we'll be back after the bath. All right, here we go. We're done with the bath and blow dry. I'm gonna brush through everything real fast. One of the wonderful parts of grooming is getting hair stuck like a needle in your skin, and I can feel one sticking me right here, and you'll have to pull it out later. So some good tweezers, invest in some really good tweezers and take care of them. And a good light, an LED light. But the hair on the animals is like a needle. So he's moving around too much. That's because this is too loose. So I'm going to tighten that up in a minute. Nice firm hold on the head here so I can control it a little bit. You can see he's moving his head a lot. It's not hurting him. If he was, I'm pretty sure he would make some remarks. Okay, I'm going to push this back so I can have more space. Okay, now I'm going to tighten this up. And that hair is really getting at me in here. Okay, we're going to come back and redo what we did. So I'm going to come back with my two. Come down. So I'm kind of doing this and this and this and this. If you just come straight down, you will draw a line and then you'll be like, oh, how am I going to get that line out of the coat, right? There's a way. You're going to come back and use your thinning shears to fix the line. Or you can use if I'm using a two, I would come back with a one guard reverse to try to erase that line a little bit. If you accidentally create a line that you made a mistake. So if you don't do the flow of the body, if I literally go this way, it'll make a line, you know, that's what I mean. You make a line that shouldn't be there. I'm going to leave some kind of a tail there. Again, we did the four on the legs, so don't waste your time on the with the two on the legs. come back anyway and be shorter. Him coming straight down and around, just how the body, it's like if I was drawing it on paper, drawing the body on paper. We did a two bar down on the head. I'm actually going to come back and just show you how you can kind of just play around. Once you learn, I don't even know the numbers of the guards by my memorization, I just know what they do. So if I'm using a two, I'm going to come back with this is a one reverse, or you can come back with a zero reverse, just to not taking off length anymore, just trying to clean up the cut. Does that make sense? This is all in the face here, so we're going to fix that. I'm going to take more off the chin because we can feel food in there, so I'm going to come back and actually do a four down the chin. This is my one, I said. So I'm not trying to still take length off. That's why I didn't do a two reverse here, which is what we started off doing, a two down anyway. I'm gonna come back with my four anyway. I'm gonna come four here. And it's not going to grab all that hair here, so I'm going to come back with a two reverse right there. See how it's like being stubborn right there with the four? Come back with a two reverse right there. If I do four reverse, it'll be really short. I don't want that. I'm doing a four just to tuck all this under here. Any flurries? It's just like hand scissoring, except I'm using a guard instead. Come back. Redoing all the legs with the four. We did it under the hiney with the four. You can barely tell. It kind of fades real nice with the two guard. Okay, I can see some of the armpit. I actually need to come back with that matted armpit, remember? I'm going to double check that. Kind of pulling and twisting at the same time. But he did pretty good. I didn't even have to use a dog up stand now, did I? He stood up pretty much the whole time. That's awesome. Rare. You got some random stuff here because it's matted under there. So you got to just come back with your 10 alone. Pulling his foot. Yeah. If you're messing with the knee, his isn't doing this, but some dogs, if you'll feel a popping there, kind of try to lay off the knee then if it's doing that. Don't keep moving it. And that's where, like, if you had the dog up stand, that's what I would, if I had a popping knee problem, then I would use a dog up stand and try to leave that knee alone. Okay, we're gonna come back reverse here. Stop. Just to kind of get those hairs here. And then we'll stop. We'll come back and scissor then. Still looks messy, doesn't it? But it'll clean up here in a minute. Okay, we're gonna go up. Try to use some code words and use them all the time. That way the dogs, every dog you groom, when they come back, they are start owners after years, they get what you're saying. They know what I mean when I say up at that point. Watch this area, I'm barely touching the skin. Okay. Keep pulling back. which is why I'm not loosening his noose more. He'll pull right out of that baby. Okay. I gotta clean this all off so I can see what I'm working with. I'm using my slicker brush, just a shaping one. The shaping slicker brush is not going to take off, or it's not going to do a lot of brushing. I'm just shaping the hair so I can trim it all up. I know I'm not taking a lot of toenail off, so I'm not worried about doing the nails first. But before you trim the feet, you want to trim the nails, because if the nails are still sticking out afterwards, you're gonna, and then you do a nail trim and now they're short, you're gonna come trim hair again, so don't waste your time doing that. There's barely any nail to take off. He's already been eyeing his toenails. I'm gonna come back with my 10 here. I could scissor here, but I'm gonna come back with my 10. Lighting is a little harder on the mobile side of the grooming, so. Straight down here. On those short shears, you can do the straight down, it's gonna just take you longer because this is one swipe, whereas the scissors is half the size, you're gonna have to do a few swipes. That's basically your difference. And the cuts, like a full long cut rather than two choppy cuts when you've got those other kind of scissors and the shorter scissors. Brush the hair back and forth in your way so you can come back and cut what's going to move later. And then like look through the hair, like look all the way through, kind of look at the angles. Use your scissors to move the hair here closed. That one piece is still matted in there, I gotta come back. Hair is so soft. Use a conditioner and the pet silk shampoo that we use. If you want some, please let me know. We'll sell it to you. Just check below for our website. This table is a good table, but it's got all these diamond cuts. I don't like that. When you pick out a table, it's like, I can't just go cutting, right? So get a table without the diamond cuts if you're gonna buy a table. And this is a hydraulic pump table. It does its purpose. I didn't want to have more electricity in the grooming trailer, so I got an electric pump. It's not my favorite. It's pretty, it pops up and down really fast. I don't like it. It wouldn't be something I buy again. On the manual pumping of the table, but in this situation, I mean, it's the best that I could do. You don't want to have too much electricity running all at once in the trailer when you're grooming. If you're running a generator, you're watching every little ampage you're using. Okay, we're looking good here. It's taking a little bit longer than I like, but anyway, we'll come back. come back and check the nail trim. This is one way you can hold the dog around like a hug, and then I can see the vein already. So like I said, I knew I would see. I can see the vein here on these ones. So this one's curled under. I can take some off of this, but not a lot. Every dog's nail is different. Every dog's nails individually are different from each other. Just because it's the same dog doesn't mean all the nails are going to have the same placement of the vein. So treat each nail differently. All the ones I can see the vein, I'm not going to trim at all. Moving that away from the pad a little bit, but I can see the vein. You can still do this here. Matter of fact, this is how I learned to do nails by myself when they were trying to bite me. Like now he can't bite my face. He'll bite the back of my arm, or any other dog would. But I've always learned that no one's going to protect your face but you. And if you want to position yourself where a dog can bite your face, then that's your face that you're going to have to live with. You can burn my arm, you can burn everything, you can cut, bite everything, but if you bite my face, it's going to be unrepairable likely, right? It'll never be the same. So protect your face and all the angles you work with an animal. I don't care if an animal is like, oh, I've never bit, the dog's never bit anybody. Protect your face. Okay. All right, now we're going to come back and finalize up this face here. Loosen this up a little bit. Brush it all forward here. You guys know I love my leave-in conditioner, so I'm going to do a little bit of that. Not right in the face, above the face, just kind of a little bit. Stop, stop. Got some food in there. Use the other side. Keeps tilting his head and stuff. It's kind of a hard angle here, but there's this area that seeps out saliva. I'm going to cut that right off. Got some food in there. I'm going to just cut that out. See more here, food. Sometimes the chunky food dried out. It does not come out in a bath. I've never had a dog grooming named Edward, ever. First Edward, ever. And military family, too. Thank you for your service. Okay, let me see. What are you doing, man? Keep looking around. Creating this some roundness here, just little by little as I move the hair. If you take a little bit off at a time, then you can maneuver better, but if you take a chunk, you're just going to have to blend all everything into the chunk. So there's a couple ways you can do it. Come here and take off the saliva area out here. See, can't even tell I wiped that, took that out. Or maybe your breath is horrible, man. So I'm gonna, I already told Mom in a text message while we were bathing that his teeth are really bad. He's 7 or so. I recommend one more dental cleaning. It'll probably help his kidneys because he's sucking down all that bacteria every day. Create that inverted V here. You can use your thinning blades, thinning shears, blending shears, whatever you want to call them. Hopefully you know what I'm talking about. I'm using the other side of my comb, which I rarely ever use. Brush that all in the way so you can come back and take it out. Sometimes there's in Shih Tzus, there's a lump here of skin. Feel it first. I know he doesn't have that. Before you trim, there was one time a long time ago, the pet parent was holding the dog and I was helping her do a free face trimming outside at an outdoor event. And I remember I nicked that baby. And I'll never forget it. So there's sometimes on Pekingese and Shih Tzus, there's some skin there. You need to take a look at it. Feel it before you trim. But his doesn't. The Yorkies usually don't have that. Face is taking a lot longer and he keeps moving his head, that's why. It's looking cute though, isn't it? Clean all that gunk out of there. Some of these whiskers, I'm leaving the whiskers. Oh yeah, it's looking cute now. It's looking really cute. Yes. Okay, let me see your face. Let me see. I'm going to take, later on this is going to change a little bit, so I'm going to take some of this out of here. It's going to grow and be right in his face. I'm going to take a little bit of that out. I like to do a tiny bit shorter, so like in a week it looks great, in a month it looks good, and then it starts to get long, right? Keep looking around, Edward. Look this way. Go up and he looks down. Go down and he looks up. It's crazy, man. Oh, look at your face. Look at your face. We're almost done. Okay, that looks good. I'm gonna come back with my tin. Do those armpits I keep forgetting about. So you wanna watch your skin flaps. And see, I can see a lot of this. This is all gonna stick out when it's matted or tangled or whatever. It's gonna stick straight out. Lift that arm up here. Kind of hook it in there. See, it's all matted in there. Okay. careful. Watch your angles and stuff. Might have to go backwards and forwards to get it. There's one more thing I need to do. Okay, tail and ears. So, yeah, I want to do the tent around the sanitary one more time, too. Because I know poop gets stuck in there pretty good, clean this up really good. And I don't want any tail stuff hanging down, so just swipe the bottom of the tail here. You won't even notice. Man, this hair is not wanting to go through though. I just grabbed whatever scissors here. Such limited space in a trailer. Okay, that's good enough for me. And we're gonna come back and do the ears real fast. I sell the hemostats and everything, but sometimes it's just not a lot of hair, so you just come in here and pull it out like this. Just little by little, just inch that hair out. Sometimes you don't even need the ear powder if it's just minimal hair like his is. Hair is going to stick to hair, so if you want to go fast, just rub it on the body here. But I started selling these things, and you can see like the hair was sticking to my fingers. So these will be listed on our website here in a couple days, or just a few bucks. They're amazing. Put this on the back of your hand while you're doing the ears. So you're going to pluck the... This one actually has quite a bit of ear hair, so I'm going to give you a powder. Just a couple taps here. And we're going to do an ear, pull the ear hair out, and I'm going to just, it's going to stick right there so I can go fast. Isn't that awesome, you guys? This little tool is so amazing. Okay, so if you want one of these, go to the website. They'll be on there either tonight or tomorrow. This one had a little bit more, so again, just stick it right onto that padding. The silicone padding is awesome. Okay, I think we're pretty good here. Double check. Just what's in the ear, remember? Okay, it's good there. All right, yeah, these are awesome. I just got them in. Okay. It's gonna be under ear something. Ear pad, puller, you'll see it. Okay, so check out the website for that. Now I'm gonna clean his ears. Go and watch more on the ear cleaning videos. This one's kind of dirty here. Use your Q-tip. You're going to swipe backwards, get all that gunk out. You couldn't tell it was there, could you? Swipe forward here. There's a little lip. And then the right back, if you go right towards the back in there, there's another little lip. All that, cotton ball wouldn't have got that out. Don't push it in, but kind of scoop it out. See how dirty this is? You wouldn't have thought that that was all back there, but it is. It's like a scoop backwards and then swirl back there. There's a lip. Forward, not digging, just barely using the tip of the entire Q-tip here. Okay, pull any excess hair. Look at that. This is really dirty. You're in my light. Okay. Still dirty. I'm gonna give it. Good to go. cleaning the ears is best before the bath, so keep that in mind. You just got too much going on. Alright, this is Edward. Thanks for watching. Be sure to subscribe, share. That helps us succeed. And support us. This is a free video for you to watch, educational or just for entertainment. But we are alive and well because you guys shop with us. And that's the only thing we really ask is if you need the tools I'm using, I would love you. I would appreciate you so much to shop with us down below. Buy the tools through us. I know there's a lot of competition out there, but you're definitely supporting a great cause. We love your business. Thanks for watching. Dee Dee Corey with My Favorite Groomer on YouTube.